In the last lecture, we talked about SU2 group and discussed in some detail that group. So here, for example, we wrote down the generators of SU2, which are half times the polymatrices, and these polymatrices we found when we were looking at this quantity here. Okay, and then I gave you for homework to check that if you look at commutators of these generators, okay, the generators are half of sigma polymatrices, then the generators obey these commutation relations, okay, where epsilon ijk, you know that this is completely antisymmetric matrix with epsilon 1, 2, 3 is 1, okay, and other elements are determined by the antisymmetric property. Also, I gave another exercise that you check that the trace of this matrix, trace one. So, trace of T11, trace of T12, and so forth. So this forms a matrix, and this matrix has, the trace of this matrix is this much. Okay. Let me say it more correctly. So the left hand side is a matrix, and you are asked to show that that matrix is proportional to identity matrix, and the proportionality constant is half. Okay, so that was the exercise. Now we want to look at SU3 group. Not that we need it in this course, but because we have done SU2, and exactly the same steps can tell you about SU3 and give you some experience with working with groups. Okay, so that's the only reason why I'm including this. So if you wish, you can omit this video without any consequences in later parts. Okay, so let's ask, what are the generators of SU3 group? Generators. Okay, that's what you want to know. So if you do repeat the same steps as before for SU2, meaning you start with writing such a matrix with all these entries z1, z2, and so forth. Okay, here, so z1, z2, z3, z4. So you do the same thing for 3x3 matrix, and then impose that H dagger should be H, that the Hermitian conjugates are equal, and write something of this sort. Okay, so that's what you're supposed to do and when you do so, you find the following, that your H will take the following form. Sorry. Where X, Y, and Z are real. Okay, so let me go back and show you. Just like here on the diagonal entries, you got the diagonal entries, you got real numbers rather than complex. That's what you are going to get here as well, that these are complex, and that's going to follow from the fact that H dagger should be H, plus you will get 0, some complex number here, Z2, and the conjugate will appear here. And 0 0 z3 z3 star 0 0, and finally 0 0 0. Okay, that's what you will get. And just as before, your Z2, you write X plus IY or X minus IY, and you will get these matrices, right? Just like what you got here, you'll get 1, 1 and minus ii. Okay, exactly the same thing will get repeated. So this is what you will get, and also the tracelessness condition tells you that this is 0. So this will correspond to 2 matrices, 2 here, 6, and although there are 3 entries here, so would be 3, but then you have one constraint, so 2. So each one is giving 2, so it's 8, 4 times 2 is 8, so you get 8 generators. Okay. Now these ones, the 2 matrices that you are going to get from here, they both are diagonal. Okay. And these diagonal matrices you can take to be lambda 3. I mean, we call lambda 3 and lambda 8 the matrices that you are going to, the 2 independent matrices that you are going to get from here. Okay, they are called lambda 3 and lambda 8, 0 and 0 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 that you will get. And I will call lambda 8, I will call lambda 8 tilde. And this matrix would be 1, 0, 0. Okay, I can choose this because these are linearly independent. Okay, so you will note that this is like your sigma 3. Okay, so this is like sigma 3 which you had, and these ones, this one will have the other 2 generators of SU2. Okay, so these 3 together, this sigma 3 and the two matrices coming from here, they will have exactly the same form as the Pauli matrices. Okay, now okay, so I will give you one exercise. Suppose TA and TB are Hermitian matrices. Then trace of TA, TB, okay, right now Hermitian is not important, but let me anyway continue writing that. So trace of TA, TB is trace of TB, TA. Okay, let me write it in brackets. So this is not the part of the statement. Okay, this is anyway true. So suppose TA, TB are Hermitian matrices, then exercise number 1, show that trace of TA, TB, this matrix that you have, is a real symmetric matrix. See, because you can interchange AB and you don't get a different thing, you get the same thing, so it's symmetric. But the thing that you have to show is that this is real. Okay, this matrix is real, that you can show. And then second exercise is, and the second exercise is that trace of TATB is a positive definite matrix. Okay, so what is a positive definite matrix? I think you are already aware of it. So if you take any matrix which is positive definite, in this case trace TATB, and you sandwich with so take a complex column vector omega A, okay, and multiply this TATB, this matrix. Okay, so you have a row here and a column here, and omega is complex, so I put a star on the left hand side. Okay, if you calculate this, this should give you a positive value. This is positive for any non-zero omega. Okay, so if you are given any non-zero omega column vector which is complex and you construct this object, it should be positive, and if it is true, then this is a positive definite matrix. So show that this matrix trace of TATB is a positive definite matrix. Now once you have shown that, then it follows that trace of TATB can be diagonalized. Okay, so because you have a real symmetric matrix which is positive definite and that can be diagonalized, which means that you can put it in the following form. It will be proportional to delta AB. So here what I mean to say is that you can choose to you can choose different TAs, okay, for which this will be true. Okay, so you are allowed to, you will be able to find such TAs for which this will hold true. Okay, that's identity matrix, and you can choose the proportionality constant to be half, but you don't have to, but you can choose it to be half, and then trace TATB is half delta AB, and this is exactly what you saw in the case of generators of SU2. Okay, so this could be done because of this property that I have given as an exercise. Okay, now another exercise. Show that T A R lambda A over half. Okay, so the generators of SU3 are given by the following matrices, which I'm going to write, where lambda A. So let me write lambda. I think okay, lambda one is okay, that's lambda one. We write lambda two, lambda two is 0 minus I 0 I 0 0. So if you look at this one, this is really the sigma 2, I think it's called sigma 2. This is sigma 2, even though this is 3 cross 3, but you can identify the sigma 2 part here. Okay, so let me remove this thing, or let it be here, no problem. And then lambda 3 is 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 0. So if you look at sigma 1, sigma 2, and lambda 1, lambda 2, and lambda 3, and if you look at these blocks, these are exactly the polymatrices that you have. Okay, then let's look at lambda 4. And that turns out to be one. This you will get directly when you are doing the steps. 0, lambda 4. Okay, and lambda 5 is 0. See, again the same thing. Of course, it is not in that just like this one, but it's exactly minus II and minus II that appears here. And lambda 6, let me write down, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay, again, you see this thing 1 1 here, it was the same in lambda 1, lambda 4 5 6 7. So 7 would be okay, and lambda 8 is the following. Okay, you can choose lambda 8 to be this, but because we are going to impose this condition that trace TATB is half delta AB, that is what we want to impose, then you can check that you will have to put 1 over square root of 3. So, if you use these as the matrices, these are called Gell-Mann matrices. Then the generators will satisfy this property. Okay. So, this is a simple exercise, and then of course, any element of SU3 you can write as the following. Okay, these are the generators. Okay, so please do these exercises so that you get some practice with playing with